another Get Ready With Me video. I wanted to recreate this floating liner look that was inspired by Viv's makeup, but I wanted to make it into a more wearable look for every day. The one that I posted on my Instagram was this teal, blue, black, sparkly combination. I actually filmed the blue look yesterday in the same setup, and it was just so out of place because of all the colors and the environment and all that, so yeah. Scrapping that. The technique and everything is still the same, so you can definitely adjust what colors you want to use. I love these clips because they don't leave a dent in your hair after you take them out like other clips do. I also have a bit of color on my lips already. I used the Floss Cheek and Lip Tint in the shade Villa, and this might be a new favorite. I love how it looks. I love the shade. I didn't think it would be this light and pink because in the tube, it looked a bit more brown to me. So to start off, I'm going to use the new M Cosmetics Face Cuddle Moisture Balm. Wow, it feels so nice on the skin. This is the first time I'm using this. It feels really soothing. So this adds a protective layer over your skin that locks in moisture. So you can also use this as a highlighter. Next, I'm gonna prime my eyes with Japonesque's Velvet Touch Primer. And then for my base, I'm gonna use Urban Decay Stay Naked Hydromaniac in the shade 30 Light. You can apply this with your hands, but I'm gonna use a brush because I don't really feel like using my hands today. I'm gonna use the Fenty 125 face brush. I'm gonna go in with a smaller brush. This is the Sigma Precision brush. Just gonna go over some darker spots, breakouts, under eyes. Now I'm just gonna lightly set with the Urban Decay All Nighter Waterproof Setting Powder. This one has a bit of a pink undertone, I feel, so I'm not gonna use too much. Lately, I've been loving to bronze first before applying the rest of my makeup. This is the Laura Mercier Matte Bronzing Powder in Soleil. I'm just gonna go quickly down the nose, then also the cheekbones, sides of my face. I didn't know I had a pimple under here. I think my period is starting really soon, so I've just been breaking out. Next, I'm gonna do my brows. I'm gonna use the Sigma Winged Liner Brush, super tiny, so that I can get a more fluffy brow. And I'm gonna use the Anastasia Dip Brow. And I like to start in this area where it's more sparse, like my hairs just have never grown back under here. And I just do strokes like this to mimic brow hairs. Okay, now we're gonna move on to the eyes. I'm gonna use the 3CE Overtake Palette. I'm gonna use this sparkly shade down here in the corner first and just apply that all over the lids and also especially like up here. I'm just gonna go up towards that brow bone area. Did you watch the inauguration? I didn't sleep the night before, so when I was looking up the schedule in the morning, I got my AMs and PMs mixed up. Like, you know how it says 12 AM, 12 PM? For some reason, I thought it wasn't gonna be on until evening time on the West Coast, which I was completely wrong about because it was on so early in the morning. I was washing my hair and getting ready. And then when I looked at my phone and saw all these inauguration photos coming out, I was like, wait, what's going on? Is the inauguration happening right now? Or is this like a pre-show? It felt like I was late to my first day of school. I'm gonna take a fluffy brush and just blend out the edges a little bit more. But I kind of feel a mix of emotions. I was a Bernie supporter, I loved Bernie. It would have been amazing to see what he could have done as president. Joe Biden obviously wasn't my first choice, but I am really excited to see all the things that he's already done in the last couple of days. And I do feel a sense of relief and hope for this coming year and for the next 4 years. And this morning, I saw some clips of Dr. Fauci saying he feels so much more free to speak about the pandemic without worrying about consequences. All I could think was, Trump is such a bully. I'm gonna go back into this palette and take this dark brown shade on the Sigma Winged Liner Brush, and I'm gonna draw like a little arch here. This will just help me figure out where I want to darken and put that brown shadow. And it's okay if it's not perfect because we're gonna do a lot of blending. Now I'm gonna take this e.l.f. defining eye brush with the same brown shadow and just blending this area right here. This TikTok video came up on my feed yesterday, and it was like, I think it was a linguist professor or something, but he was talking about people who up-talk, like when they talk, they end their sentences with like an upward inflection that makes it sound kind of like a question. And I was like, I do that. I recognize that I do that a lot. He said it so eloquently, there's no way I could repeat it, but he was saying how sometimes people view others who up-talk as kind of weaker or insecure, like that's where it's coming from. But he said it's actually the opposite, like a sign of dominance, because when you up-talk, you're actually asking the person to respond to you, or you're kind of demanding a response. And I was like, I don't know about that, but I also don't like being seen as insecure or weak because I up-talk. And I sometimes feel like because I do that, I do get a lot of comments or feedback, like they're treating me as really soft or feeble, and I'm like, I don't need this pity, like where is this coming from? And I do remember thinking like, maybe it's in the way that I talk or present myself that people think they need to like baby me, but no, I am not to be babied. I do not like to be babied. I think that's where my ego kind of steps in and makes itself known. Like I've had to catch myself like, chill out, it's fine. Like calm down on your pride a little bit. And I actually don't know that I up-talk because I demand a response from someone. I don't know where I learned that from. Okay, so now I'm just going to draw a winged line out here. A pretty sharp one. And also a pretty flat one. I'm really glad it seems you've all been loving watching the vlogs. I love editing vlogs. I forgot how much fun they were. I know I share my life on a very public platform, but sometimes I do just like to be a private person and just snuggle in my nest. And I think it's been like over a year, like even before 2020, I felt myself kind of being a bit more reclusive with my life. And now I just feel comfortable like opening back up again. And I think a lot of that does have to do with my mental state, whether or not I'm open to receiving feedback and comments on my life. Like pretty much if my wall is strong enough to take on whatever is coming, because you don't know, it's not always gonna be positive. And if I'm not in a good headspace or my heart isn't strong enough to take it, then why put myself out there to be even more damaged? That's a really bad, sad way of saying it, but I feel better now and I'm really glad I can share, and I'm really thankful for all the advice you all gave me for moving and finding apartments and apartment hunting and stuff. And I've been still looking nonstop, even though I've put like in-person tours on hold. I have just been online checking different websites, looking at other apartment hunting videos, and I'm just so excited for all my like dental stuff to be done so that I can go see them in person under, you know, the right safety situations and everything too. Okay, I realize I did a bad job of explaining what I was doing, but I pretty much was just defining this line a little bit more. And now I'm gonna take a denser brush and go into this corner with a little bit more of a dark brown shadow, like right here, to accentuate that inner corner. And we're also gonna do it just a bit down here too. Now I'm gonna go in with the flat brush and the shade again to just add some glitter back. Vibes Makeup called this a floating liner look. I kind of like that name. I've been calling this graphic liner. Some people call it cut crease liner or cut crease eye makeup. And to be honest, I don't know if I'm being like extra with this, but I just avoid describing looks as cut crease, because I remember when cut crease looks were first getting really popular a few years ago, I just didn't like that it was used as a way for monolid or hooded or Asian eyes, whatever, to get that like cut crease or crease look that Western eyes have, you know? I don't know, maybe I'm just being like extra, but I've just been trying to be conscious about using that. I do think the cut crease look has evolved to mean more, like not just trying to imitate Western eye shapes. And I've done cut crease looks before. I just don't like calling it that. I don't really mind that other people use it to describe looks that I do. I guess just for me, I don't like to. Maybe I'm overthinking it. You tell me, maybe I am, I don't know. Also, I'm applying Ardell Demi Wispy Lashes right now. There have been a few times when people have said, like, you don't even have monolids, you have a crease and all this stuff. And I was like, I just came to terms with the fact that I have monolids and that I appreciate them. And now people are saying I don't have monolids. I'm just like, I don't know. I think I have like hooded monolids. There's just so many ways to describe eyes. I really don't care what you call my eyes. I just want to be able to like help people find tutorials and makeup ideas. I also don't think I always had this crease. It's just become more prominent over the years. But when I fully open my eyes, you can't see a crease. Now I'm going to just add a little bit of brown shadow down here to like connect it, balance it out a little bit, smoke it out, yada, yada, yada. I'm gonna apply the Lawless Vintage Love blush. So now I'm going to highlight with Kaja Beauty Toy Alien. For my lip color, I think I'm gonna stick with the Floss Beauty tint because I really like it. It's just like a really nice pink. It's gonna be my new favorite. Let me try and use this as blush, because I feel like it goes really well. Ooh, that's really pretty. Oh my gosh. Okay, Floss Beauty, I'm a fan, I'm a fan. Another thing I've been doing is just wearing perfume around the house. It just helps me feel more like spruced up and lively and fresh and smells nice, and it just makes me feel, good. I have a bunch of these like little sample perfumes, so I've just been using these. Had a bunch of Sephora points that were going to expire by the end of December, so I just used it on a bunch of scents and perfumes, and they're all like tiny like this. So this one is the Nest Wild Poppy fragrance. I think this past year I've observed a lot and I've developed a lot of opinions on cancel culture and how certain people handle certain things and how opinions can change from one to the next so quickly. And so I'm just kind of sitting back and learning right now. I think there have been moments where I've been afraid to really express my opinion because I know opinions can change over time. I change over time, we all change over time, and I hate when people like hold you to an opinion that you had 5 years ago or hold you to the person you were 5 years ago, because it's not really allowing people to change their opinions and change their mind. And I know not everyone does that, so it is just me and my own projections. But now I am allowing myself to express my opinions, and I'm also allowing myself permission to change my opinion in the future based off of experience, based off of circumstance, and based off of situation. And not everything is black and white, and I don't always have the answer. It might not always be a yes or no. It might be a gray area of maybes. I think what I've witnessed a lot this year in the division, divisiveness, and you know, everything being politicized, is that it seems like there are always just two sides. There is a failure to recognize there is a gray space, like a gray area of an in-between, but it's so easy to create division when there are only two sides. But yeah, this is the final makeup look. Hope you enjoyed getting ready with me. Thank you so much for watching. If you're not a subscriber already and you want to see more videos from me, then don't forget to subscribe. You can follow me on Instagram at HeySandyLynn. Thanks for listening through this plug, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.